The third and final leg of the Triple Crown of Thoroughbred Racing is this weekend.
We are talking about the Belmont Stakes, which happens tomorrow. And while there will be no Triple Crown this year, there's always excitement.
We want to welcome back Andrew Brown with our sponsor, Twin Spires. Let's start off with big news this week involving trainer Bob Baffert and his horse, Medina Spirit, which won the Kentucky Derby under a cloud of controversy. Take it away, Andrew.
Yeah, good morning, guys. Attorneys representing Bob Baffert confirmed this week that Medina Spirit's B sample did contain the presence of betamethasone, a prohibited race day substance. The Kentucky Horse Racing Commission now has the sole authority to disqualify Medina Spirit as the Derby winner. I should point out, though, their investigation is still ongoing and will include a hearing. Churchill Downs did, however, immediately move to suspend Baffert for entering horses for 2 years. And the New York Racing Association has also suspended Baffert, which is why you won't see Medina Spirit or any Baffert trained horses for that matter running in New York this weekend.
Wow. Well, tomorrow we've got the Belmont Stakes on a high note. What is the significance of this race?
Well, Tardy, it's the last of the Triple Crown races. It's also the oldest. It's been running since 1867, and it's the longest of the Triple Crown races too, contested over the mile and a half journey. It's actually nicknamed the Test of the Champion. Eight horses line up in this year's race, as you can see, including last month's Preakness winner, Ron Bauer. The one to beat, according to Twin Spires morning line odds, is the Louisville-trained Essential Quality.
Any interesting storylines with the race?
Always plenty of interesting storylines with big races like this, Jason. Let's start with the race favorite, Essential Quality, who was also the favorite for the Kentucky Derby. He hasn't raced since then, so it's been about 5 weeks. He was caught wide the entire trip in the Derby and covered more ground than any other horse. Still finished a respectable fourth, and his trainer, Brad Cox, thinks he'll love the mile and a half. He is a striking individual, a real imposing colt, a bit like you, Jason, and he'll certainly be hard to beat. Now, there's actually a Japanese horse in this race, too. It's called France Go De Ina, which means France come on in Japanese. Should he win, he'll become the first Japanese-based horse to win the Belmont, and I'm sure there'll be plenty of fresh wasabi at the post-race celebration dinner if that happens. And now, guys, you know I'm always looking for a Detroit angle for you, and I've got an absolute beauty here. Trainer Doug O'Neill has a horse called Hot Rod Charlie in the race. Now, Doug was actually born and raised in Dearborn, and Doug has won the Kentucky Derby twice, the Preakness once, but he's looking for his first Belmont win with Hot Rod Charlie, who ran a brilliant third in the Derby. Detroit often celebrates the Hot Rod too, as we know, and I'm sure, Jason, you have a Hot Rod or two in your garage, do you? Maybe a Stingray or a Maverick or something like that? A
Mustang Bullet, yeah.
Oh, nice. Very nice.
We've got our own Maverick right here. Well, let me ask you this. How can people get a stake in the Belmont Stakes with Twin Spires?
Really easy, Tardy. Just download the Twin Spires app or visit twinspires.com. New players can take advantage of a $200 sign-up bonus at the moment. And all races at Belmont and Churchill Downs on Saturday. If the horse you bet to win finishes second or third, Twin Spires will give you your money back.
Okay, oh, wow. There you go.
Hey, Andrew, real quick, I'm guessing you probably didn't fly the Concorde, but how long does it take to get from L.A. to Sydney?
Heard you talking about this before. L.A. to Sydney, 14 hours. Sydney to L.A. a little bit quicker, 13 hours. But what I tell everyone, because I've done Detroit to Sydney a handful of times, if you leave your house in, say, St. Clair Shores or Royal Oak, by the time you leave your front door there to the time you walk in your front door back in Australia, generally give it about 24 to 26 hours, give or take. Ooh. One time it took.
Wow.
Yeah. Yep.
Thanks,
Andrew. What we're thinking. Thanks so much.
Thanks, guys. Have a happy Thursday, senior, and a fun weekend.
Same to you.
This guy's got us cracking up.
He's great.
Well, the Belmont Stakes is tomorrow. You can watch it right here on Local 4 starting at 5 p.m.
That's right. And to get started placing your bets on the race and more, visit our sponsor's website, twinspires.com.
And we will be right back.